Welcome to HearMii episode 59. I am your host, Marley Silverband, and I am joined with
TheAssailant.
On today's episode, we are going to be talking about E3 2012. E3 is next week, and it's time for us to make our predictions, or pretty much my predictions, because I'm the one that made up the itinerary. But Assailant is going to be here just to, what's the word, the assailant? What's the word?
Raise the roof.
Yeah, that's the word. But we have no site news, apparently. Do we?
Yes, we do. We have that Minecraft thing we did.
Oh, yeah, we had the power up. The
power hour of fail.
Yeah.
That was fun.
That was...
You know, the fail carried over past the recording.
Yes.
Into the actual upload. Went to a friend's house to steal his Wi-Fi, and I uploaded episode 4. Right. And then this fucking printer is printing, but ignore that. And I get home, and I check, and apparently I deleted it out of nowhere. Don't ask me how, it just wasn't there. Like, I clicked the link, it said, sorry, this video has been deleted. I'm like, okay. But then, even more so, I re-uploaded episode 4. And then I put ads on it. And then I get an email the next morning saying that, oh, we took the ads off your video because we can't confirm the copyright bullshit. I'm like, what? So I sent them an email. I was like, I know our mimicry of animals is professional and we sound like the real thing, and you could probably mistake that for copyrighted recordings, but we actually used our mouths and our vocal cords to create those sounds, but they never got back to me on that.
Oh.
Fuckers.
What's the tapping in the background? Sounds like a fapping.
I'm shaking. My leg is jiggling. It's jiggling the mic.
Well, stop.
I should stop that.
Yes.
I'm a notorious leg jiggler. If you ever meet me in real life, you're going to want to chop my leg off.
Yes. But let's get this started. Let's talk about our predictions. And let's start off with the first person, with the first company that's going to like kick off E3, and that's going to be on Monday, I believe, at like 9 in the morning. Is that correct?
Are they going to be streaming that anywhere other than Xbox Live?
I think it's game trailers as well. And then if you have TV,
would I be able to watch that on my Galaxy Nexus using Verizon 4G LTE?
Probably. Is that product placement?
No, I wish it was, because I could probably get a lot of money for that product, even though they refused to fucking update it already.
Okay. But anyways, Microsoft is going to be kicking off E3, and what do you think they're going to be talking about, the Assailant? Because I think they're going to be talking about Kinect and more Kinect and more Kinect.
I think you're wrong.
I think... Well,
first of all, they're definitely going to be talking about Halo 4, and you did not put that on the itinerary.
Oh, I forgot to put that. Whoops.
And don't forget the Gears of War RTS that got announced.
Yeah, I don't think that's an RTS. I saw that on forum.
Well, you said RTS. You told me RTS.
Well, that's what I saw on a forum. And I remembered never believe anything I see on a forum.
Was the forum NeoGAF? Because you always got to believe what's on NeoGAF.
No, it was like some... It wasn't NeoGAF.
Was it game trailers?
Except
fucking game trailers.
Probably. Fucking Shane Satterfield. It's like, here's a website all about game trailers, and they're like, maybe we should do something else other than like just game trailers, because the site seems kind of pointless. But I think they're gonna be shoving Kinect down our throats and just saying how well it works with like Windows 8 and like Windows 8 compatibility with the Xbox, and how you can like do streaming. It's gonna be like they're gonna be constantly trying to sell us that the Xbox 360 is an entertainment device, not just a gaming device. Because they've done that the past few E3s, and it just... I just think that's what they're going to do. Like, they're going to talk about Black Ops 2 at the beginning and Halo 4, and then the rest is just going to be about entertainment.
I tried... I wanted to start doing some development like just random development stuff on Windows 8, but I could never get it installed on my computer. For like the installer would boot up and it would go to start installing and then it would just stay there and not move anything. Like it would go to like 1%, it would stay there for hours and I don't know what was up. And I did not want to do that shit in an emulator because no, fuck that.
Yeah.
Yeah, randomness.
I don't know. But they're definitely going to talk about Halo 4. I forgot to put that in the itinerary, but I think it's going to be Halo 4 and then Black Ops 2, and they're going to say how Black Ops 2 is going to have exclusive maps on 360, so it's going to be the one to buy, and because they do every single year.
I'll save when we specifically get to Black Ops 2. Like some speculation on that game.
Well, just say it now, because it's...
All right. So you know how Black Ops is continued from World at War, right?
Yeah.
Now, is the Black Ops universe the same universe as Modern Warfare 3?
I don't believe so.
Because if they are, just imagine. Because Modern Warfare 3...
Imagine a world!
Modern Warfare 3... The original Modern Warfare takes place in, like, 2012. And then the next one takes place, like, 2 years after. And then Modern Warfare 3 takes place in, like, 2016, 2017, some bullshit like that. And Black Ops 2 takes place in, what, 2022?
Yeah. Wouldn't know because I didn't play any of the Modern Warfares.
I didn't play Modern Warfare 3. Well, I did, but...
You used to play Modern Warfare 3. But I'm actually interested.
I didn't pay for them, put it that way.
But you probably shouldn't say this on this podcast.
No, I went to a friend's house.
Oh, okay. All right.
Duh.
God's
God, here. Everyone knows about that.
Pirating? Pirate Bay? Who even knows about Pirate Bay?
Just go to my friend's house. Because they're guaranteed to have the game.
Whose name is Pirate Bay?
Yeah, I got it from my friend. His name's Pirate Bay? No, but really, my friends liked it all.
Yeah, it's like
they're just like big Call of Duty fans, and
Kutra?
It disgusts me. I don't think Kutra's a big Call of Duty fan. He's more like a Battlefield type of guy,
yeah,
isn't he?
Did they go like this? Okay,
he's more of a Mass Effect guy anyway.
But when going back to Black Ops 2 and Microsoft. Do you think that, like, there's going to be exclusive maps? Like Microsoft is going to, like, pull that out of their ass? Well, they don't really pull it out of their ass because they do it every year. But, I don't know. Going to contribute to this conversation?
Did Black Ops 1 have exclusive maps?
Yeah, because they weren't exclusive. They're more like Xbox got them for, like, the first month.
Oh, yeah, that's usually how it works, though, because I think, was it Skyrim? Skyrim has some sort of DLC for the first month on Xbox exclusive?
Yeah, it was the Kinect features.
No, that's not it.
Well, that's exclusive anyways.
Talk about the new DLC.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. I think you're correct on that. Yeah, fuck Skyrim, though.
Hey, I love Skyrim.
I love Skyrim too, but I just get so sidetracked in that game. I
beat that game. I got every single achievement.
I get so sidetracked. I do all the side missions. I forget to do a fucking story mission, and I'm like...
I said to hell with the side missions. At least not with the miscellaneous quests. Miscellaneous quests can go fuck themselves, because they're not going to do anything past getting 50. It's not really going to do anything for you achievement-wise.
Yeah. But yeah, that's Black Ops 2, but, for Windows 8, the reason why I put this down here is because Microsoft has been trying to sell us, like, very hard that, Windows 8 is gonna change gaming on the PC, and, I think that's a very strong statement to make, because right now, Windows... Shut up. What the fuck are you doing? Right now, Windows games for Windows Live is not as good as Steam, and Steam is kind of like the place to game on.
Yeah,
on
it is.
And
unless your game is made in Flash or C#, otherwise they can't help you. Like they'll publish your game, but don't expect the Euron. Because there's no, they don't have a wrapper for it. Because, you know, that's too much work for them. Something.
Well, what do you think? Like,
hold up, you're cutting out. Hold up. You're cutting out.
I am?
Yes. Okay, Windows 8.65233137698.
But going back to Windows 8, like, the reason, what I have in my notes is that Windows 8 is going to be connecting with the Xbox a lot more smoothly than Windows 7 is, and they're going to, like, showing off those
features. It's like Windows Phone 7 is right now. It's Xbox is directly integrated into the operating system. Mm-hmm. So you're going from day one, you just sign in to your... Did you play with the consumer preview?
No, I didn't play with it at all.
What's wrong with you?
I kind of want to download the release.
Well, when you all right. Well, when you set up an account, you set it up with your Windows Live ID. So it connects online, and then you know it gets everything for you. You don't ever have to log in again unless you go to a different account. That type of bullshit. It's like an Xbox.
What's that humming?
What?
I hear. It just went away. Now it's back.
Just ignore it.
Okay. Well, it just sounds like a poltergeist. But what I was saying with, like, Windows 8 is, like, since Windows 8 is supposed to be made specifically for tablets with, like, the weird Metro interface that they have, I can see, like say I have a Windows 8 tablet and I want to, like, go into the marketplace.
Oh, but it's not going to be made specifically for tablets. That Metro UI, desktops too. Professional or not?
Well, what I'm trying to say is, if I have a Windows 8 tablet, I want to go over to the Xbox Live Marketplace and download a game. That I can download that game on my tablet, and it will.
Well, that's over
to my 360 when I get home.
I'm not entirely sure about that because, you know, ported games, stuff like that. It's like, I think it's going to be more like Steamworks. Like if it's available for PC or Xbox, you can download it for both and just pay once.
Yeah, I can kind of see that.
Like how Steam does it with PC and Mac. Other than that, it's not, you know, you're not going to be able to play Gears of War on your PC all of a sudden.
No, I'm not trying to say that, but like Steam kind of already has.
That's what it sounds like you're implying. So I'm just clarifying. Okay.
All right.
But
yes, this is just speculation. Just us like talking.
But they've been. Microsoft's been going into Windows and ripping out old legacy code for the start menu. Because for the consumer preview, there was a hack where you can get the start menu back on the Windows side. And they've now removed that, all the code relating to the start menu. So the start menu and the start button are absolutely not there anymore. Wow. It's the start screen, which is the Metro UI. That's what it's going to be from now on.
I feel like going and playing around with the release preview.
Like people have been complaining like, oh, I'm gonna have a screen dedicated to a start menu. No, you're not. You know, if you have two screens, you have one screen that does another thing, and then you just open up another app on another thing. You know, it's the exact same shit, just without it. Just think of instead of a desktop, you have a whole start menu. And it's a lot neater. And it updates, like it has live tiles and shit like that. And I think that's pretty neat because that's better than the gadgets bullshit on Windows Vista and Windows 7.
Yeah. You just mentioned gadgets. I completely forgot about them.
I think they still have them on the desktop for Windows 8. I think. It's been a while since I last used it, but I think they're still there. But I'm definitely going to be using live tiles a lot more than the weather gadget. Yeah.
I think I will be using live tiles as well. In my opinion, it's going to take a little bit getting used to. I should actually be playing around with the release preview, but I'm just afraid to, because this computer that I have is really my production machine.
They're going to be. You could just download a virtual machine and just do it from there.
I tried doing that, and I don't want to go through the trouble.
It's not that hard. You just you downloaded the the ISO. You start up an image, and then you have it installed to a virtual hard drive, which the emulator does for you. And then you just launch it from there. Of course, it's going to be slow as shit, but better than nothing.
Yeah. But it does. Windows 8 does look really nice, but I think it's going to be weird for them to talk about it at E3, but I don't see them, like, ignoring it, because that's pretty much their big release coming out this year, and that's why I don't think there's going to be a new Xbox at E3,
I was trying to mess around with Visual Studio, but I was not going to be able to do anything without multiple screens.
But
in an emulator, you can only have one screen.
I really don't think Microsoft is going to be talking about the next Xbox, or at least, like, if they do, like, mention something, they're just going to show, like, a preview like they did with the Kinect. Like, just show a trailer of, like, here's what we have coming down the pipes, or, like, here's a glimpse into the future of Xbox 360.
They might say something at GDC, though.
Well, GDC already happened. GDC next year?
No, there's two GDCs.
There is? No, there isn't.
Yes, there is.
Well, I just figured out something. But
isn't there? Because there was one year where it was two GDCs. I could have sworn. Yeah, there's multiple GDCs.
What problem?
Upcoming GDC Europe, Cologne, Germany, August 13th.
15th. Oh yeah, Microsoft is really gonna announce the next Xbox in GDC Europe.
You never know.
I just don't see that happening. But
I mean, it's better chance of it happening in Europe than GDC Canada, or GDC China.
We're going to have a lot of angry Canadians and Chinese people commenting on this podcast. But
I'm not going to try and imitate a Chinese person. That's just racist.
That is racist. That's just racist because you're... Never mind. Because
I don't know Chinese.
Yeah. But, we're probably going to see a teaser, but in my opinion, the next Xbox is going to be coming out in maybe a year and a half. Maybe next fall 2013.
It's gonna be the X Tesseract. not the Tesseract from the Avengers. The real 4-dimensional cube Tesseract.
It's gonna be called the Direct Xbox.
That's what the original was called in development.
I know. That's what they should do. Just be cool. But
hey guys, remember Direct X?
Well, it's still relevant now.
I mean, it still is DirectX 11, but yeah. they don't like calling it DirectX 11 anymore. They call it Direct 3D now.
Yeah,
like that's their name for it, even though everyone else still calls it DirectX.
Yeah, but yeah, that's what I think. What's going to happen at Microsoft's press conference? But we'll find out on June 4th or Monday, whatever the date for Monday is. And, I don't think we're going to be doing a live blog of that.
Yeah, it's June 4th.
Yeah. Should we do a live blog? I don't know.
I could do a live stream from my phone. I could stream my, my lunch. Just me eating my lunch while watching E3.
No. But, moving on to, my favorite company. I don't know about the Assailant's favorite company, but Nintendo is got a lot of things to cover on their shoulders.
I want to know more about the Wii U in terms of development.
I think,
in fact, I still don't know anything about 3DS development.
Well,
so they
pretty
need
much,
to step up their game.
Pretty much, like, Nintendo has to sell us on Wii U, because I am about, in my opinion, I am halfway sold on Wii U, but I don't, if it's going to cost like more than $400, if they tell me that like right now, I don't want to buy it. But if they tell me like after, like,
no, it's going to cost $400.
I think it's going to be around $300. They don't want to be pushing past $300.
Then again.
But yet again, they're not going to be talking price in relation.
They are. I mean, how much does the cheapest Xbox cost right now?
It's $200.
All right, so the parts are definitely going to be somewhat cheaper. The CPU, not so much, because that's using a completely new architecture. It's just using a new form of PowerPC developed for the Watson project. So that's technically a new architecture for the CPU, so those aren't going to be any cheaper. But the graphics, the GPU is probably going to be, I think they said it's going to be a 6000 series.
Well, those are all rumors and speculation. We don't actually know the specs because Nintendo won't actually release them.
I mean, I have a 6700 on my PC right now, and it runs Crysis somewhat decently. It can't do very high, which saddens me because it can't do very high.
But I think the only thing that's going to bring up the cost of like the Wii U is probably going to be that controller if they decide to put multi-touch in that touchscreen, which I don't think they're going to do. I don't think they're going
to. You know what? You know what they should do? They should do it like the Galaxy Note.
What they should do is they should do it like.
No,
but I see the
they
Wii
should
U.
Do it like the Samsung Galaxy Note. It's got a multi-touch screen with a stylus.
Why did you fucking mention that fucking phone? I don't know what that phone is trying to be. Is it a phone?
It's
a fucking tablet? Is it a fucking PDA?
It's both. It's the best of both. That's the tagline.
Okay, what I see the Wii U is
phone,
for right
tablet?
Now. What I see the Wii U is for right now is just like a giant DS, because you got the I think it's tactile touchscreen,
How the fuck would it be tactile?
No.
If it's tactile, it's going to be clicking. You know what?
Okay.
You know what's tactile? A keyboard.
Yeah.
Tactile.
Okay. Okay.
Buttons are tactile.
I know.
Touchscreen is not going to be tactile.
I know. Fuck you. But I can't think of the word of what the DS touchscreen is.
Resistive?
Resistive touchscreen.
Versus capacitive? No, they have to put a capacitive touchscreen.
I won't forgive them if they don't. Multi-touch is going to just be too expensive for them, and Nintendo's not.
It's not too expensive.
Yeah, it is.
You want to know all right.
Multi-touch.
iPhone 4S, you want to know how much it actually costs Apple to create, to in parts, how much it costs Apple to make an iPhone 4S?
No, because we're going to be going off topic.
No, I'm just going to be. It costs them $109 to make an iPhone 4.
Well, if I know Nintendo, they're going to be pinching pennies in order to, like, keep the cost
Apple
down
sells
of
them.
The system. Keep the cost
Apple
down of
sells
the system.
Apple sells them
so
for $700, so that's like a four. That's at least $400 profit. I mean, it's not like $700 exactly. It's like six something, like $650. Some shit like that. And like, the Nokia Lumia 900, because they were comparing it to the Lumia 900, and that one costs two something, like $250 to make. Mostly because of the I don't even remember. I should pull up the chart before I start talking about shit like this.
Well, going back to the Wii U, I think that Nintendo is going to spend like probably around 80% of the press conference talking about Wii U and trying to sell us on Wii U. Like, they're going to be talking about games, especially third-party games, not first-party as much, but just trying to sell us on third-party. Because right now, like, the Wii for about 5 years hasn't really, like, there hasn't been a lot of good third-party games. Like, there's been some hits, like Deadly Creatures and Mad World, but they really need to sell us on Wii U with third-party games. And,
sorry, it's $190.
Okay.
That the iPhone 4S costs to make.
Well,
but you want to know how much the iPhone 4S touchscreen costs?
Not really.
$37.
I don't know. Well, but what do you think about the Wii U, Essie?
I really should know. I need to know what I'm going to be doing in order to get one, because I want to be one of the first people to have one, but I don't know how I'm going to be doing that.
What do you mean?
I don't exactly want to have to camp out because I have morning classes next semester.
No, I asked you, what do you think of it? Like, will
then
you
again,
buy one?
They're going to release it on a Sunday, aren't they?
I don't know.
So I would
I asked
be
you a question,
to go on
though.
At midnight and get one.
You're going to get it at midnight no matter what? Because I am like 50% sold on Wii U. And
no, I'm completely sold on it. I got to have it. Yeah,
I don't know.
But the thing is, I need to figure out how I'm going to pick one up. So I don't know when
I should just pre-order.
I don't think GameStop does pre-orders for.
They do.
They do? Mm-hmm, they didn't do it for the Wii. Oh wait, no. Yes, they did. All right, then I'll just go to GameStop. I should go there before E3, before they start doing the marketing promotion. Should.
Well.
I should have done that last year.
Sold on Wii U, and I'm about 50%.
I should have done it last year, when they announced it.
Yeah. I need to see games, because I haven't seen any games. It's all been speculation, except for the Assassin's Creed 3, which is probably... I'm tired of Assassin's Creed. Even though, after I saw that trailer for Assassin's Creed 3...
I pre-ordered it, and I have the case, and
you don't know anything on Assassin's Creed 3 yet, and you pre-ordered it for... I don't know. You just saw that trailer of the guy throwing an axe at that guy's face.
No, I didn't even see the trailer. I didn't even know the game existed until, like, the day before Mass Effect 3 came out. And then I went there, and I was like, if you pre-order this right now, you'll get this tin case. I'm like, sign me up. I got money to burn.
Well, that's nice. That's nice for you. They're going to be spending, like, Nintendo has to spend pretty much all of their press conference talking about Wii U, but the next thing they're going to be talking about is talking about 3DS games. Especially, they'll be talking to me, because I'm a 3DS owner, and I'm starting to... Like, I like my 3DS, and I pretty much play it every day. I like the eShop. I like the games that are on it, like Mario Kart, but they need to, like, show me more games. Like Luigi's Mansion 2, see if that's actually a game that's going to exist, because they haven't talked about it since last E3.
New play control Luigi's Mansion.
that series that they're doing is dead.
Hold up, you're breaking up again. Try now.
Okay, I'm back.
What were you saying?
I'm back.
You said, no, what were you saying? That's something.
What, that's something?
I said something about new play control Luigi's Mansion. You said that's...
That series is pretty much dead.
Oh. Because I was still getting comments and views on that video. I think I made it private because I was tired of having people comment like, oh, is this real? I don't know what an April Fool's joke is. I can't tell the date. I don't know what a date is. I can't read.
Yeah, they don't know what a date is because they've never been on one. Oh! Up top.
Oh, burn. Oh.
That's some 3DS, new 3DS games, especially third party. I think Nintendo's going to spend a lot on third party, and they're probably going to talk about retro games, new project, which I think is going to be the Star Fox and Metroid crossover. What do you think of that? That's been exploding over the internet.
I hope not, because that's gonna... Alright, you remember how Metroid Other M was? It's gonna be like that, but 10 times worse.
I don't think so, because supposedly Retro is...
Remember Star Fox Assault?
Exactly. I try not to remember it, but thanks for putting that back into my memory bank. But it's... If Retro is behind the Star Fox Metroid crossover, I have complete faith in Retro. I don't have complete faith in Team Ninja, because Team Ninja is...
on Club Nintendo, and I finally filled out my post-play for Metroid Other M, and I gave it like a 60, and I was like, oh, I wish Retro did it.
Well, it still sold like 500,000 copies. Metroid Other M. I actually thought about playing that game again, but then I had it like in my hand, the game case in my hand. I opened it, and I was like, "No, this game's kind of shit. I don't want to play it again."
I gave up on the game.
I beat it, but it's frustrating.
No, I gave up on it. I got to this one boss. I was like, "You know what? Fuck this."
What boss?
It was the one after Ridley.
That one.
Remember me?
Remember me?
That's all I'm going to say.
Remember me?
I barely remember that game, but I remember that part.
Remember me? I don't know.
No spoilers.
The game is just fucking spoilers for a 2-year-old game.
Hey, I said no spoilers. God damn you.
Just bleep me out.
I will.
Well, you spoiled fucking Gears of War 3.
I didn't mean to.
Which, by the way, I started playing again. But let's get back to Nintendo.
I didn't realize that asking you about that one part was going to ruin that part.
Let's just get back to Nintendo and E3. So what do you think is going to happen?
By the way, did you beat Skyrim yet?
No.
Did you get to the part where the thing and the thing and the thing? And the thing and the Fushroda?
Shut up. What do you think is going to happen at the Nintendo's E3 press conference?
Oh, yeah, remember what we said? Maroon 5 is going to come out, and Adam Levine's going to start singing Payphone. And
no,
Reggie's going to come out with Payphone.
No, you got this completely wrong. I said that Reggie is going to come out on stage, going to have like a white microphone in his hand, and he's going to start singing Payphone, and then Adam Levine will come out, and like they'll do like a duet, and Reggie's gonna like take his guitar from him. He's gonna do like a guitar solo, and then at the end there's gonna be fireworks, and then Reggie's gonna announce Just Dance 4 for Wii U exclusive.
And then they're gonna announce Adam Levine Rock Band.
Adam Levine Rock Band, and not even Maroon 5. Maroon 5 Rock Band. Well, that was interesting. But, yeah. I also think Joe McHale is going to host the press conference.
Oh, remember that, the video with Reggie? With the hashtag Reginator?
Yes.
Remember that weird-looking 3DS sort of looking thing that, yeah. I said it didn't really look like a 3DS, like a current
3DS. It's a 3DS.
Nah, it might be a new 3DS.
Oh, you think there's gonna be a new 3DS? Like,
you never
3DS
know.
Lite?
You never know.
Because if there
I'm
is,
just
I'm
saying,
punch you in
I could have sworn that the 3DS cover was... I mean, I haven't actually seen one because all the display units are forced open. There's no way to close them. I don't really remember what it looks like. But
it looked like a regular 3DS. But if there is a new 3DS, I might actually punch you through this microphone. Because
no, you're gonna go to a payphone, and then you're gonna call me, and then you're just gonna scream.
And then.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
But you think there's gonna be a new 3DS?
No, I'm just fucking with you.
You really, but I don't know. But yeah, that's Nintendo. We really digressed on that topic. But let's move on to the worst.
Hey, tangents. Tangents are our bread and butter. No, they're our bread and butter.
I can't believe it's not butter.
I can't believe it's not Vita.
Nice segue. We're gonna be talking about Sony now. The worst company ever. Oh, wait, whoops. The best company ever. Now
you
can't say
anything
bad.
Nothing.
But yeah, that's Sony's E3 press conference is happening on June 4th, I believe, at like 5 p.m., like it always does. And it'll probably last like 2.5 hours.
Isn't it? Don't they usually do it the same day as Nintendo? Like right after? Because Nintendo's not till 5th, aren't they?
No, it's June 4th.
When's Nintendo doing it?
I think the 5th. I don't know.
Nintendo does it the 5th around...
9 a.m.
You're right.
And then...
Sony is usually right after.
They're usually like at 5.
No, they're usually like right after. I think it's like Ubisoft that's usually at like 5.
Oh.
Remember that one time?
Oh,
where,
I forgot about this.
I don't even remember that... Who was it that got on stage for Ubisoft and just bored the living shit out of everyone?
Oh, is it the Mr. Caffeine?
I don't remember.
Or is it James Cameron?
They talked for
45 minutes about
yes.
fucking Avatar.
Yes, it was James Cameron, that's right.
Mr. Caffeine.
I was gonna say James Cameron, but I didn't want to say it. I didn't want to sound like an idiot. But now that you said it, I'm just gonna agree with you. Yeah, I think it was James Cameron.
Okay, but moving on to like Sony's E3 press conference, I think that they really have to do something about the PlayStation Vita, because that fucking handheld is like, I like it. I've actually played with it, and it's a pretty good handheld for what Sony put into it, but there's no games for it, and Sony's just not really supporting it all that much. And I feel sorry for my friend that bought one, because there's just nothing for it. So they really have to like show some support for the Vita. Like maybe bring Kaz Hirai out and have him talk about the Vita and how great it is. And also they have to do something about the Move, in my opinion, because the Move has really failed. Like Kinect is overshadowing it, and like, I don't know.
I mean, that's what happens when you try to launch a product in the shadow of the Wii.
Yeah, but but I think they're just gonna kill the Move, in my opinion, because
integrate it into the PlayStation 4.
Speaking of that, I don't think there's gonna be a PlayStation 4. Sony is losing so much money right now, and there's no way that they.
No, they're making money on the PlayStation now.
No, they're not.
They are.
They're losing money on every single PlayStation sold, because they dropped the price so much.
No, they're not. The parts have dropped considerably. They're making a profit.
I don't think so.
No, they're in the black.
So are you trying to say that they're making a profit and then they just had like the biggest layoff in their company in 30 something years? A million people lost their jobs at Sony, and that's because the PlayStation 3 isn't turning a profit?
No, it's because the Sony Vio is an overpriced piece of shit. Clearly.
And so there are Sony TVs.
Hey, I have one of those. They're all right,
I guess. But I feel like, going back to the PlayStation Vita, though, I feel like that if in order for the Vita to succeed even more, they have to do like a price drop for that thing. So like maybe whether it's $50, $100, $200, like they have to, like, in my opinion, I think $50 price drop would be perfect. Because
I still really don't understand who thought it was a good idea to put a touch panel on the back.
As for a
company that's like, oh, we don't have gimmicks, you know, they sure do like to strap them onto their new products.
As for someone that actually used the Vita and used that back touchscreen, like, I can definitely see it screams gimmick. And I found it very uncomfortable to hold, because when I was playing, like, it was Golden Abyss.
Yeah, because when I play a handheld, I like to wrap my fingers, you know, across the back, because it's just natural.
It secures it, because what if you drop it? Like, when I was holding the Vita,
Yeah, you literally have to hold it by the edges.
Yeah, and like, I don't have anything supporting that, and I would, and since it was my friend's Vita, I didn't want to drop his $250 like handheld. But going back to the price drop, I think that would be perfect thing for them to do, to like a $50 price drop, and have it, and have $199.
You know what bothers me though?
Can I finish my statement? Keep going. I think that would be perfect for them to price the Vita at $199, because then they can say, oh, we're just $30 more than the 3DS. It's like, that's a perfect place to be for a price point for a handheld. And I think if they do that, I think they'll start flying off shelves. Because in my opinion, the Vita is the most powerful handheld on the market right now.
You know what bothers me? The Xperia Play from Sony. It's not getting upgraded to a touchscreen sandwich.
And you're complaining why?
Because they were like, I don't know, they were like trying to make it like the greatest phone on the planet, and they're not even going to bother upgrading it.
Well, that's, you know what?
The Nexus S already has ice cream sandwich.
You know that you're the first person to actually mention the Xperia Play. That's the first time I heard that in about 6 months? No, longer.
Last time I heard anything about the Xperia Play is August, and I was in Europe.
Yes.
And that was because Minecraft was exclusively launching on it.
Yeah. And look at Minecraft now. But,
I cannot play... Like, I think Minecraft would have been good for the Xperia Play, because I cannot play Minecraft on a mobile screen. It's too... It's...
You need physical controls.
I can't... Yeah. I need a real analog stick to move around.
You need a dual analog stick?
Well, moving isn't really the problem. The problem is looking. It's looking and placing and breaking blocks.
Yeah.
That's the problem, because right now it's just touch. The entire thing. It's just you touch it and then that moves your screen. It also breaks the blocks and then...
I don't know.
I wonder if Notch ever worked in alternative methods of control, because if he did, you could hook up your Wii Remote to a special app and then plug in a classic controller and then probably play Minecraft through Bluetooth. Maybe.
Oh. But, yeah. Going back to Sony, though, I think also that they're going to be talking about, of course, like PlayStation 3 exclusives like The Last of Us, which I'm actually kind of excited for. I don't know about you. It's Naughty Dog's next game.
I am very excited about The Last of Us. Excited that the Game Informer that I got, I didn't read. Well, I haven't read any of my Game Informers.
Oh.
Not a single one.
Okay. But I think The Last of Us is probably going to be like just a Uncharted like post-apocalyptic version. But I'm anxious to see what that game looks like, because I trust Naughty Dog to like push out pretty good games. Yeah.
You can trust Naughty Dog to do some good shit.
Yeah. And do you think we're going to see The Last Guardian? Speaking of games with last in the title.
The what now?
The Last Guardian.
What is that?
You know, the never-ending story character game?
Huh?
Never mind.
I literally have no idea what you're talking about.
The Last Guardian is that it's the game developed by Ico and Shadow Colossus developers?
Nope.
Okay, never mind. Obviously, you don't know about it because Sony has not freaking marketed that game, and I think it's dead. But yeah, that's Sony in a nutshell.
I mean, it doesn't help that I've been putting all my focus into Android right now.
Well, Android's not going to be at E3, so...
I know. Well, I.O. is in a month, I think. Google I.O.
Well, whatever. But that's us. That's our pre-E3 talk. That's pretty much me talking about pre-E3. But I think we need a break. Do you need a break?
Let's hear a word from our sponsors. And we're back.
We're here, and we're going to be starting What Are We Playing? And we're going to start off with The Assailant.
Hold on. You're breaking up again.
Why?
I don't know. There's people in this house. It's crazy.
Get better internet.
But I tried. They said my phone lines suck. That's pretty much what they said. That's pretty much what they told me. Even though my ISP is the exact same company as my phone, which is kind of funny in a sense, but also infuriating.
Well, you want to know what's infuriating me?
What?
I'm not gonna say.
Anyway, what are we playing?
Anyways, what are we playing?
You're kind of far from the mic.
What are you playing?
I was hearing echo.
I was leaning back.
Yeah.
What are you playing, Assy?
You don't want to do that, by the way. Just pointing out there. What am I playing? All right. Well, I talked about Skyrim and I beat that like a month ago. And by beat, I mean I got every achievement. I didn't complete every single quest. That would never happen. That's not gonna happen. I was playing Borderlands a little while ago.
Oh, you're getting pretty good.
Just
Borderlands 2?
Are
you ready for that?
I already have my money. I had my money down a year ago. Well, not a year ago, but
you and
like
your
6 months ago.
You and your
pre-orders. I had my money down more than 6 months ago. I think it was.
Why do you pre-order at GameStop? Why?
Because usually they're the ones that have like all the cool shit. Like if you pre-order GameStop, you get Moxie's.
Pre-order GameStop, you get an exclusive map pack. Pre-order
Look,
Best Buy. Oh, I hate those pre-order bonuses. It's ruining the gaming industry. It's ruining it.
I don't like them because I'm a collector by nature. Like I want to have them all, but
yeah,
I can't. I can't pre-order and pick up a game at every single location that sells it.
Which is dumb.
Otherwise, it'd be broke, and I'd have five copies of every game, and I'd be broke.
Like Storm, have five copies of Smash Bros. Brawl. Wow, that's really dated reference.
Everyone listening to this is probably going to be like, who the fuck is Storm?
No, they're going to be like, everyone's going to comment because I said Storm, and you're going to put Storm in the tags. Well, what else have you been playing?
I gotta think.
Spotify?
Pokemon, I've been playing Spotify. It's a mini game collection. You press the play button a lot. it's actually very close to what Skrillex does in real life. You just press the play button.
Fucking Skrillex. Why'd you have to fucking mention him on this fucking podcast?
Because I like ridiculing DJs that all they do is press a single button.
Yeah. You know what we should do? We need to create a new intro and to make it dubstep.
I have FL Studio, and I have no idea how to work it.
It's FL Studio again?
Yeah.
What's FL Studio?
Fruity Loops. It used to be called Fruity Loops. Now it's FL.
What's Studio. That then?
It's like, it's, you know Monster Cat, right? I always link their music.
Yeah.
It's pretty much what most of those artists use.
I'll play around with it. Is it free?
There's a demo.
I'll try it.
If you want the normal edition, I think it's $100. And the producer's an extra $100.
Fuck that.
Play around with the demo.
The
demo's free.
What else have you been playing?
I've also been playing Robot Unicorn Attack Evolution. what?
Nothing. Go on.
I was playing The Sims Social on Facebook because I hadn't played it in like months, and this girl came on and she was like, hey, can you get on Sims and accept my request for a hammer? And I was like, sure. I mean,
okay.
I know her from class, but yeah.
Okay, so she's cute. At least you got that going for you.
Well, blonde, too.
Ooh. I'm going to give her a call.
Call her from a payphone? Or are you going to give her your number to call you maybe.
What else have you been playing before I crack up?
Forza. Forza 4. There was a sale last week or something, and I bought a bunch of cars.
That's cool.
I got the Tesla Roadster S. That is a very, very quiet car.
Because it's electric.
I went from driving that to a Lamborghini, and never again, because that's a huge contrast.
Should I get Forza 4?
If you like racing games, totally. I mean, it's GTA, a sim racer. So, if you like Storm and you don't like, you know, you don't like being realistic with your driving, then don't get it. But otherwise, you should get it because it's a really nice looking game. It's very accurate with the sounds, at least, because people, you know, they go back and forth with Forza and Gran Turismo, and I gotta admit, Gran Turismo, the models are slightly better looking than Forza 4, but Forza 4 definitely has better sounds.
Speaking of Forza 4, what about Forza 5 at E3? Did you see that?
I can, actually, because they announced Forza 4 after Forza 3 came out. Oh. Forza 3 came out in 2010? Or was it late 2009?
2010, I believe.
Yeah, so I could see a Forza 5 being announced.
Yeah. On the next Xbox.
I thought Forza 4 wasn't going to be good because I thought that they had reached their limit with Forza 3, and then with Kinect added, I thought it was just going to be like bad, but I was completely wrong.
Wait, you have Kinect?
No.
Oh. Okay, never mind. But what else have you been playing?
Oh, I tried out Crysis with my new GPU. Obviously, I've been playing Minecraft.
Did you try out the Minecraft for Xbox 360?
I did. I told you I didn't like it in the video.
I know, but what if they don't?
It was like, what, 6 minutes in?
Yeah, but what if the people listening to this podcast didn't watch that video?
Then go watch the fucking 6-part fail-a-thon.
Power hour of fail.
Exactly.
But, Minecraft Xbox 360 really sucks, in my opinion. It's like there's no mods, you're playing a dated version of Minecraft, and I don't know. Plus, you don't have mouse controls. So, yeah.
But, on the bright side, the frame rate is pretty godly. Like, it's very, very high. Like, that frame rate is,
yeah,
like, just your pants amazing. Even though I can achieve that on my PC now. But still, it's pretty good. It's pretty solid.
I know. But, is that all you've been playing?
I'm trying to think. You start, I'll butt in if I remember anything.
Well, don't butt in, but wait till I finish. But I've been playing a lot of...
Oh, Halo. That's right, Halo.
Okay, well... Nothing new there. But I've been playing a lot of PC games. I'm just going to go into my Steam library and just go down the list.
That's what it was. Portal 2.
Oh, yeah. I've been playing Portal 2 a lot too, as well. I tried out the new test chamber initiative, I think that's what it's called.
I did that too. I didn't... I'm not very good at making puzzles, let's put it that way.
Well, neither am I. I'm not very good at, like, map creators either. Like, I tried Halos, but the thing I like about Portal 2 is, like, map editor is... I was able to jump in and create, like, a test chamber in about 5 to 10 minutes, and one that actually worked. The controls... are very, like, it's very easy and very intuitive to just jump right in and just create a puzzle. And I can see how, like, I look in, like, what the community has created. I want to create some of those puzzles that the community's done. It probably will take me forever, but I think it's a nice little thing. But, yeah. You still there, Essie?
Yep.
I've also been playing some Team Fortress 2. Still don't get that game, but a couple days ago I downloaded The Binding of Isaac, and apparently have you heard of that game, The Binding of Isaac?
Nope.
It's $2 on Steam, and I got the soundtrack for 99¢. It was one of the Steam deals, and
Heard about this one game. It was I don't remember what it was called, but it was this like horror game where you had like this
amnesia
angel. No, everyone knows about amnesia. It's like they call it the weeping angel or some shit, and like you blink and you pretty much die or some shit like that. It was weird. Immortal has a video of it if you want to watch.
I've been playing The Binding of Isaac, and that game is good, but I really wish it had gamepad support, because the controls are just the controls aren't necessarily that good. But it's a nice little dungeon crawler, and apparently Edmund McMillen,
that guy we talked to on episode 55?
Yeah, actually. Thanks for bringing that up, Assy. But he created The Binding of Isaac in less than 100 days. And he apparently did this as like his vacation, which is, that's actually fantastic, and actually makes me feel like a piece of shit that doesn't do anything except make a podcast when I feel like it. I've been playing that, and I played some more Uncharted. The game's still good, I guess. And I played Minecraft, obviously, some Mario Kart at my 3DS. Mario Kart 7 is actually fan-fucking-tastic.
That trailer with the Japanese girl, that was incredible.
I love that game though, but that trailer is amazing.
I love how they all of a sudden call it Mario Kart 7.
I figured that they should call it Mario Kart 3D. That would make sense.
I was actually confused for a second when you said Mario Kart 7. I thought you were talking about Mario Party, because that's usually the Mario game with numbers in them.
Yeah, I know.
But Mario Party 9, yeah. I play that at GameStop, and
it gets bad.
Yeah. I haven't bought a Nintendo game since. What was the last Nintendo game?
Oh, do you want to talk about? Do you want me to talk about my 3DS games that I've been playing?
Yeah, go right on.
I got a 3DS. I bought it on impulse at 2 o'clock in the morning. But that's another story for fake outtakes, probably. I've been playing Resident Evil Revelations, which is actually probably the best-looking game on the 3DS, and it's actually...
Isn't the new Prince of Persia supposed to be on 3DS and supposed to, like, look extremely good?
Prince of Persia? I've never heard of that.
I think it was Prince of Persia.
You mean Kid Icarus?
No.
Oh. No, I haven't seen it. But, and then I got Mario 3D Land, or Super Mario 3D Land, or Super Mario Land 3D, or whatever Nintendo wants it to be called. I played that and I beat it. It's pretty good. Not the best Mario game, but Mario 3D Land is probably the game on the 3DS that uses 3D perfectly, in my opinion. And then I have Ocarina of Time 3D, and that's pretty good, obviously, but you already knew that. Except for Storm. Well, he thinks Twilight Princess is better than Ocarina of Time. But,
aren't they the same?
Yeah, they are the same. And then, I went back to Skyward Sword, and, I don't like Skyward Sword as much. I don't like it.
I still haven't played it.
I never recommend that you play it, because it's like a Zelda game, and everyone should, like, every Zelda fan should play a Zelda game?
Like here's the last three games I bought for the Wii, right?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Tenchu Shadow Assassins, used on Amazon. Let's Tap, used on Amazon. Cursed Mountain, used on Amazon. You want to know which ones I've actually played? Let's Tap. You want to know how disappointed I was when I finally played it? Very.
Wow.
I was very disappointed with Let's Tap because I had waited 3 years, like 3 years to be able to play this game, and then only then did I realize that the concept was actually not that great.
Yeah, but
That kind of sucks.
Well, that's what hype does.
I mean, it was only like $3, but yeah, it kind of sucks.
That's what hype does for you.
I mean, I have Cursed Mountain, and I have Tenchu, and I plan on doing a recorded series on them, but I don't want to play them until I get that concrete.
You mean on Let's Play?
Whatever. I don't want to play them until I have that concrete, you know, because my capture card's like a piece of shit, so I need a new one.
Oh.
Fast. And I need a way to be able to capture and see on my LCD.
What kind of capture card do you have? Don't you have the same one as me?
Look, yes, I think so.
Why don't you take advantage of that Sly Fox deal? The Roxio capture card for $70 that Machinima is doing?
I mean, I don't have money because I just spent $200 on my phone.
Oh, well. Okay. But I'm trying to think of what else I played.
But what I need is something that I can record with and then be able to see the preview in full screen with no lag. Because Pinnacle gives you a very small window, and I can't see shit in that window.
Oh.
Not see shit. And as you all know, the Wii doesn't do HDMI, so I don't have an HDMI, I don't have like a composite or component input on my monitor, so I can't do that like I do with my Xbox. So I'm going to need to figure out something to do with that. So until then, Tenchu and Cursed Mountain will not be played.
Okay. But that's all I've been playing. So I think we're going to end this. You hear me, Assy? You hear me?
I really need to get around to playing my games, because I bought 5 games and then I ended up just playing Mass Effect the entire time.
Mass Effect 3?
No, Mass Effect 1. This was back in January. I bought 5 games. I only played Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2 out of those 5.
Well, that's good.
Like, I started a little bit of Assassin's Creed. I started a little bit of Prince of Persia, but I just haven't touched them since.
Oh. Well, I think we're going to wrap this up. Do you have any plugs that you want to mention?
Visit my blog and my Twitter at TheAssailant. Even though I haven't tweeted in weeks, just ignore that. Just follow me anyway. Because, hey, I don't tweet, which means you don't get flooded, which is good for everyone. Everyone wins.
Yeah. And also follow me on Twitter. It's at PigeonGamer. And follow my blog. It's called...
You never explained why you're calling yourself Pigeon Gamer.
It's an inside joke.
Well, I want to know. It's not fair.
I'll tell you after the podcast. All
right.
But follow my blog. It's called The Geek Out Corner. It's a Tumblr blog, so it's nothing special.
I have a Tumblr, too. I only have one post on it, though. You want to know what that post says?
No. Suspense. Leave suspense in there. Have them go to it.
I think it's the assailant. It's either the assailant or the assailant 6661.tumblr.com.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm going to check.
Visit hearmii.com for latest.
It's the assailant. Theassailant.tumblr.com.
Yeah.
I'll put a link on the video.
Visit hearmii.com for your latest news.
Video with quotation.
So are you done?
Go.
Visit hearmii.com for your latest news in gaming, technology, and nerd shit.
And fail. Don't forget to fail.
And fail. Minecraft fail. My name is Marley Silverbrand. And I got one more plug. Everyone who has a PC, go out and buy the Humble Bundle PC pack. It comes with
Which Humble Bundle? Because
the Humble Bundle, it's the newest one that came out. It comes with
because four... I have the Mojang from Mojang.
It's the one that I don't know. It has four fabulous games. It has Psychonauts for PC, Swords and Sorcery, Bastion. If you pay the full price, I will look it up. I don't like fact checking.
Wait, is this a Humble Bundle of just?
I'm looking it up right now.
The Humble Bundle I have is the Mojang one. Notch and everyone else, you know, they just made games in like 72 hours or something, and I paid like $5, and I put most of it into, I don't remember what I put most of it, actually no, it was 10, but I don't remember what I put most of it into. And you know what? I haven't touched any of the games.
Well, this one I'm talking about is the Humble Indie Bundle 5, and it comes with Amnesia Dark Descent, Psychonauts.
Ooh, Amnesia. I got to get this.
Psychonauts, Limbo, Sword and Sorcery. Link? Hmm?
What's the link? Is it still up? Can I still buy it?
Yes. You
Humble
have
Indie Bundle
days.
5. Humble, go to www.humblebundle.com, and I can pay any price I want, right?
Yeah, and quit interrupting me. You can pay any price you want.
Oh, they have Limbo.
You can pay any price you want, but if you pay more than $7.75, you unlock Bastion. So pay $10, and all the money goes to Child's Play, a terrific charity, and also you get all the soundtracks for all the games. As
I see EFF on here too.
Yes.
It goes to both. Don't you get to choose?
It goes to Child's Play.
Or EFF. They're partnered with EFF then?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. But they're fantastic games. Humble Bundle is a terrific charity, for the gaming industry.
All right, I'm going to spend $7.60. I'm going to spend $7.76 then.
Well, and also these are terrific games. Bastion, I hear, is terrific. I really need to play it. And also you get
I played
soundtrack.
The demo on Xbox, and it's actually the watch Yahtzee's review, put it that way.
No, don't watch Yahtzee.
No, watch Yahtzee's review. He likes Bastion.
Oh. But yeah, support this, and Child's Play is great. So yeah.
And you know what's great about it? It does this through Amazon, right?
I believe so. I didn't.
Yeah, because when I did Mojang's, it went through Amazon. So it goes through Amazon, so you don't have to put in any credit card as long as you already had it on your Amazon.
Yeah.
So it's safe, secure, DRM free.
Mm-hmm. But terrific. Buy it now. So especially like Limbo is a fantastic game. Psychonauts is unbelievable game. And then I haven't played Amnesia, but I hear it's a fucking horrible, scary game. Not horrible, like bad.
Oh, it's scary. You gotta watch like.
No, I don't want to watch anything because I want to buy it and play it and just shit my pants because I'm so scared. So, and Bastion, I hear, is terrific, and I can't wait to play it. And
I'm going to give 67 cents to each developer.
Don't be a dick. It's not going to the developer, it's going to fucking...
No, I'm doing, actually, I should put more to the charity, a lot more.
Give $10, because then you'll unlock on Steam.
Huh? $10 for Steam?
Pay a dollar more and you'll get a Steam key in addition to DRM-free direct downloads.
What does it say? Oh, wait. Pay a dollar or more.
Yeah, I just said that.
But if I'm already paying $7.75, don't I already get the Steam?
I don't know. Probably. You have to pay more than the average.
What's the average?
$7.75.
All right, then I'm paying $8.
So yeah, terrific charity, terrific games. Anyways, my name's Marley Silverbrand, and I am signing off.
And I'm the Assailant, and I'm purchasing this. Bye. Where's the Steam? Oh, click here for your Steam keys.
Well,
click the button to redeem your Steam key.
How do you? Where do you input them?
You go to Steam, I think.
You go to Steam. No shit. Yeah. Should I get that? Huh? I'm here. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
I'm here. I'm here. Hello?
Oh. I think I lowered my volume by accident.
Anyways, should I get Forza 4?